Dear students, today we shall discuss how to find out area of a curve when the curve is given by polar equation. So the statement of theorem is, if the equation of a curve in polar coordinates be r is equal to f theta, so this is the curve r is equal to f theta, where f theta is a continuous function of theta, then the area included between the curve and two radii vectors theta is equal to alpha and theta is equal to beta is 1 upon 2 alpha to beta r square d theta. So this is one radii vector theta is equal to alpha, this is another theta is equal to beta, and this is the curve r is equal to f theta. So the formula for finding out area between the curve r is equal to f theta, theta is equal to alpha and theta is equal to beta is 1 upon 2 alpha to beta r square d theta. Let's take few examples. First example is, find the area of the cardioid r is equal to a into 1 plus cos theta. Now we have already discussed tracing of this curve. This curve is symmetric about the initial line, so we take values of theta from 0 to pi, right? So this is known as cardioid. Now we have to find out this total area. So what we shall do is, we'll find out area of the upper portion and then multiply it by 2. So therefore required area is 2 times area of the upper half of the curve. Now for upper half, theta varies from 0 to pi. So therefore this is 2 times 1 by 2 0 to pi r square d theta, which is equal to 0 to pi r square d theta. Put the value of r from here. So r square is a square into 1 plus cos theta whole square d theta, integration from 0 to pi. 1 plus cos theta can be written as 2 cos square theta upon 2. So this comes out to be 4 a square 0 to pi cos theta by 2 raised to the power 4 d theta. Now put theta by 2 is equal to phi, so therefore d theta is equal to 2 d phi. So therefore area is equal to 4 a square. Now limits of phi will be from 0 to pi by 2 cos phi to the power 4, and in place of d theta we write 2 d phi, which is equal to 8 a square 0 to pi by 2 cos phi to the power 4 d phi. Now we shall make use of gamma functions. So here say m is equal to 4 and sine phi to the power sine phi power is 0, so where n has equal to 0. So therefore this is equal to 8 a square gamma 4 plus 1, yani ki gamma phi by 2 into gamma 1 by 2 upon 2 gamma 4 plus 0 plus 2 upon 2. Gamma 5 by 2 is 3 by 2 into 1 by 2 into under root of pi. Gamma 1 by 2 is under root of pi, and gamma 3 is factorial 2, that is 2 into 1. So therefore this comes out to be 3 upon 2 pi a square. Let's take next example. Find the area of the curve r square is equal to a square cos 2 theta. Again this curve is symmetrical about the initial line as well as about the line theta is equal to pi by 2. Tangents at the polar theta is equal to pi by 4 and theta is equal to minus pi by 4. And we have already discussed tracing of this curve. So we have to find out complete area of this curve. So we shall find out area of this shaded portion and then multiply it by 4. So therefore required area is 4 times area of upper half of one loop, which is equal to 4 times. Now apply the formula 1 by 2 r square d theta. Limits for theta are from 0 to pi by 4. Now put the value of r square, in place of r square we put a square cos 2 theta. So this is equal to 2 a square times. Now integration of cos 2 theta is sine 2 theta upon 2. Limits are from 0 to pi by 4. So put the limits, 2 gets cancelled. A square into sine pi by 2 is 1 and sine 0 is 0. So a square into 1 minus 0 is a square. So therefore, complete area of this curve is a square. Let's take third example. Find the whole area of the curve r is equal to a cos 2 theta. Now we have already discussed then the curves of the type r is equal to a cos n theta or r is equal to a sin n theta. If n is odd, then number of loops is n, and if n is even, then number of loops is 2n. For example, if we have say curve r is equal to a cos 4 theta, then number of loops will be 8 because 4 is an even number. Similarly, if you say r is equal to a sin 3 theta, so in that case number of loops will be 3 because 3 is an odd number. Now because in this case we have r is equal to a cos 2 theta and 2 is an even number, so number of loops will be 4. Okay, now to find out limits for one loop, we put r is equal to 0. So we have a cos 2 theta is equal to 0. That means cos 2 theta is 0. Therefore 2 theta is plus minus pi by 2. So theta is plus minus pi by 4. So therefore for one loop theta varies from minus pi by 4 to plus pi by 4. So therefore whole area of the curve is 4 times area of one loop, which is equal to 4 times. Now area of one loop, now here theta is 0 and along this line theta is pi by 4. So we find out this area of this portion and then multiply it by 2 to get area of one loop. So this is 2 times 0 to pi by 4 1 by 2 r square d theta, which is equal to 4 times 0 to pi by 4. Put the value of r square, a square, cos square 2 theta d theta. Now cos square 2 theta can be written as 1 plus cos 4 theta divided by 2. So we have 2 a square into integration of 1 is theta, integration of cos 4 theta is sin 4 theta upon 4. Limits are from 0 to pi by 4. So put the limits, so we have 2 a square into pi by 4 plus 0 minus 0 plus 0, which is equal to pi a square upon 2. Let's take fourth example. Show that the area of a loop of the curve r is equal to a cos n theta is pi a square upon 4n, n being integral. Also prove that the whole area is pi a square upon 4 or pi a square upon 2 according as n is odd or even. Now as discussed earlier, the number of loops in r is equal to a cos n theta is n or 2n according as n is odd or even. Now to find out values of theta for one loop, we put r is equal to 0. So we have a cos n theta is equal to 0. So cos n theta is 0. That means n theta is plus minus pi by 2. So therefore theta is equal to plus minus pi by 2n. So therefore for one loop theta is missing. Okay, for one loop theta lies between minus pi by 2n to pi by 2n. And because the curve is symmetrical about the initial line theta is equal to 0. So therefore area of one loop is 2 times 0 to pi by 2n half r square d theta. 2 gets cancelled, put the value of r. So r square is a square cos square n theta d theta, which is equal to a square times 0 to pi by 2n. Replace cos square n theta by 1 plus cos 2n theta upon 2 and then d theta. Take this to outside, so we have a square upon 2. Integration of 1 is theta, integration of cos 2n theta is sin 2n theta upon 2n. Limits are from 0 to pi by 2n. So put the limits, this comes out to be pi a square upon 4n. Now this is area of one loop. Now we have to find out area of the whole curve depending upon n is odd or even. So in case n is odd, the total number of loops is n. So therefore total area is n multiplied by pi a square upon 4n, that is pi a square upon 4. And if n is even, then the total number of loops is 2n. So in that case, total area is 2n multiplied by pi a square upon 4n, that is pi a square upon 2. Next example. Show that the area of the limb cone r is equal to a plus b cos theta, where a is greater than b, is equal to pi times a square plus b square upon 2. Now if you trace this curve limb cone r is equal to a plus b cos theta when a is greater than b, shape of the curve is like this, similar to the chordoid, but instead of pole we have this point. So required area is 2 times half r square d theta, limits of theta are from 0 to pi, which is equal to 0 to pi r square d theta. Put the value of r. So we have r square as a plus b cos theta whole square d theta. Squaring, we have a square plus 2ab cos theta plus b square cos square theta d theta, which is equal to 0 to pi a square plus 2ab cos theta plus. Now cos square theta can be written as 1 plus cos 2 theta upon 2 d theta. Now integrate each term. So we have a square into theta plus 2ab integral of cos theta is sin theta plus b square upon 2 integration of 1 is theta and integration of cos 2 theta is sin 2 theta upon 2. Limits in each case is from 0 to pi. So put the limits, we have a square pi plus b square pi upon 2, which is equal to pi times a square plus b square upon 2. Let's take last example. Find the area of a loop of the curve r is equal to a sine 3 theta. Now in this case, you know there are number of loops is 3. So for finding out values of theta, we put r is equal to 0. So a sine 3 theta is 0, that means 3 theta is equal to 0 pi. So therefore theta is equal to 0 and pi by 3. So therefore one of the loop should be loop. Therefore one of the loop lies between theta is equal to 0 and theta is equal to pi by 3. So therefore area of a loop is 1 by 2 0 to pi by 3 r square d theta. Put the value of r. So we have 1 by 2 0 to pi by 3 a square sine square 3 theta d theta. Sine square 3 theta can be written as 1 minus cos 6 theta upon 2. 2 into 2 is 4, so this is a square upon 4 0 to pi by 3 1 minus cos 6 theta d theta. Now integration of 1 is theta, integration of cos 6 theta is sine 6 theta upon 6. Limits are from 0 to pi by 3. So substitute the limits, we get area of one loop as pi a square upon 2. Now in case you are asked to find out complete area, so because number of loops in this case is 3, so therefore whole area of the curve r is equal to a sine 3 theta is 3 times area of one loop, that is 3 into pi a square upon 12, which is equal to pi a square upon 4. Thank you so much.